Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm going to be showing you how to make some pretty realistic looking fire in After Effects, and this is going to be completely generated in After Effects. You don't need any files or anything to go with it. You just take a bunch of different effects, put them all together, and you can get this fire look type thing. You probably wouldn't want to use this like for a campfire, but I'm thinking for like a torch or something like that in the background. This could be a really useful effect. Anyway, so let's do this. File, new project, and open a new comp. I would recommend 1080p and 30 seconds. Click OK. And you're going to need effects and presets open. So if, I mean, well, I guess you could do, effect and then whatever the effect is, but that's just more complicated. So we're just going to be using effects and presets. So hit Control 5. Let me see. Yes. Pretty sure it's Control 5. Control 5, yes, Control 5 to open effects and presets, or you can click Window and click the checkbox next to effects and presets if you don't have it open already. Okay, so click Layer, wait a minute. Click there. Layer, New, Solid. Okay, and we're going to want this to be either a light orange or a light yellow. It's going to have to be really bright, yellowy or orangey color, because if you think about it, people think of fire as being red or orange, but if you look at right at the middle of fire, it's really not yellow or orange. It's usually like a white, or at least that's how it shows up on cameras. So we're gonna pick something very close to white, but with a little bit of a orangey or yellowy tint. It sort of depends on the type of fire you want, but I'm gonna sort of go. I'm probably going to go with this. And by the way, if you just want to copy, if you want to use the exact same thing I'm using, you can just put this number in right there and you'll get the exact same color. So I guess it's ECD4AD. And so click OK. And that brings up this. And now we need to draw something that vaguely resembles fire. You don't have to do some sort of big fancy fire. I'm just talking like. You don't have to be even careful, really, at all. Just sort of something that vaguely resembles a fiery shape thing like that. Okay, that's perfect. And now we're going to need to drag on a bunch of effects. And it takes a lot of tweaking, so we're going to be going to the effects and then going back and then going back and then going back to the effects again and again and again until we get it just perfect. So click in your effects and presets and type in, oh, what is it? Radial blur and drag that on. Oopsie. Drag that on to your solid. Okay. And now type in glow. And take that one, drag that on. And now, what is the last one? Turbulent displace. Drag that on. And this is what we have so far. So does not look a lot like fire, but we're gonna fix that now. Okay, so I guess we will start with the glow. So I guess you can shut off the other effects by clicking right there. Okay, so we're gonna, and I guess minimize them too, it'll make it simpler. There we go. Okay, so click on glow, and let me see, color A and color B. We're gonna need to set the glow colors from original colors to A and B colors. And then color A is, I believe, closer to the outside, and color B is closer to the inside. So it might help to have a picture of fire to reference, but if I'm remembering right, we're going to want to pick a reddish orangey color that's sort of dark, almost brown, for the A color. Click OK. And then for the B color, we're going to want to, I think, do a very light ish orange. Might be a more yellowy, but we'll check that in a second. Okay, and so now we're gonna boost the glow radius. About there looks good for me, so I'm doing 57. Glow intensity, we're gonna, let me see, take that up a little bit. Drag that up a little bit, like 155, I guess. And still not looking a lot like fire, but we're working on it. We might come back and tweak some of these settings a little bit more, but I think that's all we're going to do for right this second. So minimize glow and turn or open and turn on radial blur. There we go. Okay, so let me see. What is this? Okay. We're going to change the type from spin to zoom. And it's getting closer. And then I get make sure the center is about in the center. By default it should be, but you just want to make sure. Turn the amount up a little bit. Maybe not that much. We might come back to that and turn that up more later. Okay, so now we can minimize that for a minute and open turbulent displace and turn that on. Okay, so this is what we have, and this is just sort of changes the shape and makes it weird. I'm sure that was a very, very technical explanation of what that does. Okay, let's get on to this. We are going to turn the complexity, this is going to make a huge difference right here, turn the complexity to 10. Okay, wow, what just happened? Well, we made a very simple shape. Should be holding down shift to go quickly. From that to a very more complex, I didn't say that right, that was bad English. Don't talk like me. Much more complex shape thingy here, and it's really weird looking. But it, right now it's just a picture, and so we need to fix that. Let me see, what do you do here? So many settings to remember, guys. Okay, so zoom out to about there, 6.25% is what I'm doing, but you'll just have to play with it and see what you like. So we're going to click offset turbulence, and make sure you click the stopwatch right here. If you don't click the stopwatch, it won't work right, because then you won't be telling it to change over time. Click this button here, and that'll bring this up, and then you just want to click down below the fire about there, and we might go back and tweak this, like I said. And now click the O on your keyboard to go to the end of the clip. Click the button again and put it at the top. And so what we just told it to do was to move from right here. Click U so you can see the keyframes if you want. See this point here? That's saying at this point in time be right here, and then we drag to the end or hit O, and then at this point in time we want it to be here, and then After Effects will automatically put in all the frames in between there, and that is going to distort the fire and make it look like it's burning-ish. But let me see what we have right now. That's looking pretty good. That's looking pretty good, but it's not probably crazy enough. I don't know. And also like something you can do if you want to just adjust your mask, if that looks too straight to you, just straight up and down like a line, you can drag in some of these points. Oh, whoops. Control Z to undo. You can drag in some of these points like this and make it more of a finer top if you want. Da 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 da. Yeah, I'm not an amazing artist. darn it. Undo that. Okay. So, just sort of deuce, I don't know. Something like that. That looks maybe worse than what I had originally. I don't know. I'll just leave it like that. But I mean, you know, just keep whatever you want. It doesn't really matter. And so then this is what we have. That's pretty good. Couldn't you sort of see that if you have like a torch right here? Couldn't you see that sort of just burning on the end of the torch like a Pirates of the Caribbean movie or something? I don't know. Anyway, okay, so now we're going to take the evolution and set that to like, I don't know, let me see, 6. And that just sort of makes it weirder. Complexity is at 10, size. Okay, let me see what the amount does. I'm trying to remember that setting. Oh, yeah, well, that's how much you want to displace it. So if you have it just at 0, then it's not going to look much different. If you turn it way up, it'll look like way crazy, and that's probably not what you want either. So yeah, just probably leave that about 35 or something like that. And now size, this, you just basically turn it up for a crazier fire. So if we set it way up here, we're going to have a fire that's sort of like, whee, dancing around all over the place. That's probably not what you're going to want, unless you're trying to make like a little floaty fire dancey thing that floats around the screen, which could be interesting and useful in some movie, but Most likely not. So I'm going to click here and hold down shift to go back quickly. So let's see. What about this? That's pretty good. I don't know. Might be a bit crazy. Maybe we'll take down the size a little bit. Bring it to 140. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. So yeah, that is essentially it. Although there is one other thing that I've discovered. If you're not happy with this and how it looks, there's one other thing I discovered that can make it look a tiny bit more realistic. And obviously, since we're generating it, it's never gonna look as realistic as if you just like filmed it or used just like a stock footage or something. But it's pretty good for not that much work. Okay, so click layer, new adjustment layer. And we're going to type into effects and presets exposure and drag that on to the adjustment layer. Okay, so I noticed that this is, normally when you have blown out footage, you can just drag down the exposure a little bit. So I noticed it actually helps probably a tiny little bit if you take down the exposure and down on the gamma a little bit and then offset it slightly. And that looks very dramatically overdone. But then we can click the adjustment layer and hit T and turn down the opacity. So there it's completely invisible and there it's completely visible. And we just want to find somewhere in between that looks about good. So maybe something like that. And now let's preview it. Okay, well, there we go. That's what we got so far, and that's pretty much it. There might be more things you can do to it. That's all I have thought of right off, but I'm pretty happy with it. I think it looks pretty nice, especially for being generated completely in After Effects. And I mean, if people see that, they're gonna think fire. I mean, it doesn't. It looks a lot like fire. And also, like, if you're not happy with the colors in here, you can click back on your solid, open up glow, and you can change these colors. If you want the outsides to glow blue, then you can put blue. And the outsides will then glow blue instead of orange. Of course, that makes it less realistic. Almost looks like a muzzle flash there. But anyway, so yeah, just you can mess with these colors and make them how you want them. And remember, the inside of the fire. Which w is the color for the solid, which was a very light orange. So if you want to change that, it took me forever to figure this out for some reason. You just click layer, solid settings, and then you can click here, and then you can change the color to whatever you want. But it's not going to look good unless it is a really, really light color, preferably a yellow or an orange. Okay, guys, I hope this helped you out. By the way, I post free pre-keyed video. I said that wrong. I post free pre-keyed stock footage and effects and free pre-keyed video effects. That's what it is. And yeah. Anyway, basically that means that you can just drag it onto your footage and you won't even have to take out a black background or a green background and just poof, it's done already because I did it for you because I'm nice like that. You're welcome. So just browse my channel if you want. Click on a video that says that it's free video effect, and then just click the download link in the description, download the video file, drag it into After Effects. You'll have a pre-keyed effect, which are kind of hard to find, believe it or not. So okay, yeah, that's the end of this tutorial. Hope it helps you out. Leave a video response with your video that you use this effect in if you want. I'll check it out, let you know how you did, and yeah, please leave tutorial requests in the description. Man, my brain, guys, you can't. Oh my gosh, I'm sorry. Okay, please leave tutorial requests in the comments below. Thank you. because, it's difficult to come up with a bunch of tutorial ideas. So if there's anything specific people want help with, I'm more than happy to make you guys tutorials. Okay, bye, guys. I will see you next week.